Play track 10.
I'm sorry about this.
Now you know I wouldn't have Brandy anyway. Not until little Emma gets here.
Oh, I can't wait.
She's gonna be everything that we prayed for.
No, I mean, I can't wait to get you drunk again.
No, there's your Tommy gun. One thing at a time.
Oh, no, we've got to get you started growing my son, Ferris.
Oh, gosh, slow down. Let's get this one here first.
Okay. I wouldn't want to wear you out too badly anyway.
Oh. You're not disappointed that she is a she, are you?
No. No, Emma's perfect just the way she is. Just like her mama. Besides, I can make her into my little Tommy boy.
Oh, you mean tomboy.
Uh-uh. Nope, mean Tommy boy.
Now I will give you a son, Tommy. And we can start right after Emma's born.
The journey, it'll be worth the wait.
We can always practice.
Practice?
You know, the process. So when it comes time to make your son, you won't be out of practice.
I don't think you have to worry about me being out of practice. 1,000 years could go by. I would never forget an inch of you.
Now that is what a girl likes to hear.
Now Herman's coming over here to drop some stuff off here in a little bit.
Well, he better hurry. He's not gonna have anybody to open the door for him.
Danger.
in at 12 o'clock.
HQ, bring the connoisseur around.
Mr. Gunn? Tommy Gunn? The explosion would have completely vaporized anyone still inside the house, I'm sorry to say. It's impossible to tell if your wife was taken out or not before it happened at this point. We are going to need a full statement from you. The Cynthian unit will escort you to the station.
Mr. Gunn, if you will, sir, please come with me.
Well, give us just a minute.
Yes. Of course, Herman.
Okay. I'm really sorry, son.
They're dead, Herman.
They?
Ferris. And our unborn daughter, Emma.
Okay. I had no idea.
Wish you could get your hands on that, don't you, Gunn? Think you could take us all out? Huh?
No, just a few of you, boy. Seeing the ensuing chaos, your goons here would shoot each other.
Rest easy a moment, ladies. Jazreth will be along shortly.
So, how we doing, Tommy?
About got him right where I want him, Bobby.
Good. I'd hate to see where we'd be otherwise.
They know anything, they're not talking.
Detective, my name is Jazreth.
Good for you.
This is a very nice gun you have here. It's a vintage of sorts. It's not produced anymore.
Yeah, well, it's not mine. But I'm gonna return it to the owner after I shoot him dead with it and throw it into his grave.
Detective, I'm a go-to guy in the Cathedral Legion. I get called in to crack a few hard nuts every now and then. I was just enjoying a nice scotch, minding my own business, and I get this call out of nowhere about detective named Tommy Gunn who showed up at one of our little haunts. And, of course, he was quickly overpowered and taken prisoner. This is the Cathedral Legion, after all.
I'm not a detective.
You see, here's the problem. Whenever the Cathedral Legion needs something special done, they call me. And these days, our organization is up to some very fun and interesting things. Most likely, CPU would not approve. And that could ruin our good fun.
You are just breaking my heart.
So you see, your friend showing up here, who just happens to be an active CPU agent, and you, a former Confederation Special Forces operative. Well, naturally, I find this quite alarming.
Well, it depends on how much fun you and your boys are trying to have.
You see, I'm here now, away from my scotch and my friends, to ask you one very important question. Just what kind of fun do you think we are up to here specifically?
I don't know anything about your fun. I came here for my friend.
I'm not known for my patience, Detective.
Or you're right, Hook, evidently. See?
What about you, Agent Kincaid?
Go to hell!
Well, I think we're done here. In the end, it doesn't matter what you two think is going on. Shodaya, take care of our little problem here. And make it slow. Very slow.
Just wait until you see the ease that this completely severs the leg.
I'd like to pass. Something I should tell you.
Oh, really? I'm all ears.
First, I'm not a detective. And second, I like my legs exactly where they are, boy. Nobody move! Alright. Alright. And me and my friend, we're gonna be leaving now. Well, gentlemen, I do wish that we had all met under different circumstances. After all, you only get one chance to make a final impression. Bobby, what the hell are you doing?
I'm sorry, Tommy. You just don't get it. What these guys are doing, their fun, it's power beyond anything you could imagine. It's why I came here, and it's why I'm still here.
You stupid butthole! I came here to save you!
And now, I'm going to save you. Just walk away and leave this place. I'll take it from here.
What the hell's going on here? What's this fun you guys are planning? Mommy, I don't know what it is you're trying to pull here.
You shouldn't know. You don't want to know. Just go.
Nobody move! CPU agent!
Excuse me, Mr. Gunn? Take it easy, Mr. Gunn. I'm your friend.
Most of my friends are dead. And the ones that are alive aren't anywhere near here right now. And I don't recognize you, buddy.
I come to you in good faith.
You know, when you've had a day like I've had today, you learn to use extreme caution. What do you want?
My name is Ivan Kincaid. I just graduated from JSU, degree in criminology.
Well, good for you, boy. Your mom and dad must be very proud.
Yes, sir.
Wait a minute. Did you say Kincaid? You any relation to Bobby Kincaid?
Yes, sir. She's my older sister.
Oh.
Last word was that she was working. She was working something real big, trying to infiltrate the Cathedral Legion.
Listen, kid. I'm only gonna say this one time. You may have your fancy law degree and all that happy fluff, but you don't know anything about the Cathedral Legion, and you don't want to.
Look, Detective, I have some information that I think you'll be interested in.
I'm not a detective, kid. You know, I went there to save her, kid. I had no idea what she had got herself into. And to be honest, I still don't know. I thought you'd like to know.
But you're sure that she's dead? Makes matters more pressing then.
What do you mean?
My sister, she mentioned yesterday that she was working some big infiltration gig against the Cathedral Legion. She said that they're making some kind of big move.
They're fun. All right, so what was the move?
Didn't say, except that it involves some big shot software designer and some kind of an exchange for an item. An item that could give the Legion the power to take over the world.
I doubt that, kid. The Cathedral Legion would not only have to deal with CPU, but there's still the Confederation to contend with.
Believe me when I say, Detective, that with whatever this item is, they would have the power to do both.
Well, I don't know what to tell you, kid, except that it sounds like a blathering bunch of crap to me. Why don't you go back to school and learn to be a doctor or something?
Oh, no. I want to be a detective, and I want you to show me how to do it.
I'm not a detective, kid. All right, fine. Who's involved in this drop?
Big players. The best the Cathedral Legion has. I only have two names. A Jazareth and a Nebuchadnezzar.
Nebuchadnezzar. Did you say Nebuchadnezzar?
Yes, sir.
I hope you have a gun, kid. Because if Nebuchadnezzar's there, it's gonna get real messy.
Oh, yeah.
CPU is an honorable establishment. The problem now I have is a dirty little rumor that I've caught wind of. The extremely dangerous crime syndicate, the Cathedral Legion, is rumored to have infiltrated the ranks of CPU itself. Naturally, you can understand why I find this to be unsettling. CPU holds multiple law enforcement and Confederation defense contracts to our sentient cyborg program. This organization must protect the trust of our greater community at large. We've all but taken over the law enforcement duties of our tiny little planet, and if not for the ongoing Brief 5 terrorist actions, we'd have likely taken over the Confederation duties as well. For this system to be compromised in any way is a clear and grave danger to our society and the utmost importance here on the board. We will find out if any of these rumors are true and bring any double agents before our great justice system. And finally, let me assure each and every one of you here today, if it is discovered that any of you have ties to this dangerous and nefarious organization, you too will suffer that same fate. Consider yourselves, all of you, duly warned. Dismissed.
Good evening, Mr. Afgard.
What's this all about, gentlemen?
I think you know what this is all about.
Ah, yes. The rumored Cathedral Legion infiltration of CPU. And you two, its best agents. There is a rumor that I'm curious about. A rumor that the Cathedral Legion has a secret weapon. A weapon so powerful it will allow their leader to rule the world.
That's no rumor.
Excellent. And the money I spent on it was wise.
The item will be ready for pickup tomorrow, sir.
I want you two to oversee it personally.
Yes, sir. But there is one possible hiccup with the plan, sir.
I do not like hiccups, Jazareth. But I'm more than confident that you two can handle it.
CPU operatives saw the drop was today, and they infiltrated our rank with two of their agents.
Well, I can see to it that that doesn't happen tomorrow.
There was a small-time detective with them, sir.
A detective?
A detective, Tommy Gunn.
Seriously? That was his name?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sounds like a 1930s comic book hack, if you ask me. And what happened?
The two CPU operatives were quickly dispatched, but Tommy Gunn got away.
And what was the problem?
I have a past with this man. It goes back before the liquidation of the 13th Legion.
That was a long time ago.
Only if he knows I'm not involved now.
Why, Nebuchadnezzar? Do I detect fear or the like in you?
No, sir, not at all. But this guy, Tommy Gunn, he has an impeccable knack for interfering. We lost a lot of good men out there today thanks to him. This thing is too big and it's too important to let my personal history interfere.
I'm quite sure this Detective Gunn is just happy to survive the encounter today. The plan will proceed with no altercations. If this Detective Tommy Gunn shows up or interferes with any way, well, you two already know all too well how to remove a man's face, one tendon at a time.
Yes, sir. The plan will proceed. If Tommy Gunn shows his face, then Tommy Gunn will die.
I love getting my way.
Dr. Strampton, I presume. I believe we have business here.
Excuse me, sir?
That's close enough, kid. What are you doing?
Hey, look, I was just night fishing over there and my boat sprung a leak, man. You think you can give me a hand, huh?
You know what?
My boat. Fishing.
Get to the count of three, Pete. One. Two.
All right, Dr. Stranton. Let's do this. You show me yours, and I'll show you mine.
You know, I really wasn't aware of what you folks really wanted me to build for you.
And that's not your concern. What is, you make our order to specific perimeters. You build the device and hand it to us. We hand you what you were promised, and we both go our separate ways.
But, you know, that isn't exactly the way it would be now, is it, Jazreth?
Excuse me?
I'm no murderer, and I'm no enslaver of men. I'm not like you and your thugs. And I can tell you, I finished your precious Trojan device. But I can promise you, you will never, ever get to use it and release it on humanity while I'm still alive.
I see. Then consider it your payment, if you're allowed to leave here alive. But then again, that just wouldn't be our style now, would it?
Everybody freeze!
Gunn. I told you he would come.
Detective Gunn. May I ask what you think your coming here is going to achieve? Your luck will be very different than yesterday.
You obviously don't know my luck, boy.
I know why he's here. It's perfectly obvious. Gentlemen, meet the great Tommy Gunn. A man with the heart of a lion, the memory of an elephant, and the stench of a skunk. He's come here today with a vendetta. A vendetta against me. My question for you, Gunn. Why is it your rage towards me for something that happened so long ago causes you to risk and sacrifice your life here today? Tell me, how is the wife and child? Forgive me. You probably think you can escape here too, don't you? Well, today your luck has run out. No magical or divine intervention will save you now. Surely even your luck runs out sometimes, Gunn.
I wouldn't be so sure.
Screw this!
To admit, Detective, I admire your courage and grit.
I'm not a detective.
Find his companion. Don't bother to capture him, just take him out. You really want to know what this has all been about, Detective?
This is a mistake.
you're looking at is the single most powerful item ever held by any man.
Okay.
And with it, we will control the world.
Control the world.
Yeah.
You? Maybe you're going to control the world.
Oh, God, that's a good one.
I told you that you and your thugs would never get this device.
Shut up. Dr. Stratton, you have exactly 1 second to change your tune.
Well, you know, I'm sorry, but I'm just gonna have to take this to my grave.
Then that's where I'll send you.
Move unless instructed to do so. Throw your weapons down and lay face down on the ground. Your compliance is mandatory in 5 seconds.
They have personal shield generators, Jazareth. I believe you better do what they tell you to, boy.
What is this Trojan device?
Probably the biggest mistake of my life. My God, what have I done?
Dr. Stratton!
I'm not having time for this.
Do it!
This is your last chance, Dr. Stratton. Give me my Trojan.
I guess you're just gonna have to kill me.
As you wish.
Maybe you'll settle for this instead, boy.
So ends old feuds, Tommy Gunn.
We have to
get to Dr. Strand. Trojan is all that matters.
God. Speak to me.
Guess I blew it. Not much of a detective, am I?
Hey, don't sweat it, kid. You're a better detective than I'll ever be. You be quiet. I'm gonna get you out of here.
Surrender now. Your compliance is mandatory.
Why am I not surprised?
How you doing, Will?
You know, I don't get it. Why do you keep doing this to yourself?
Doing what?
Trying to get yourself killed, Gunn. You know, ever since the transient incident, I find you here all the time. Every week. You know you're not a detective.
That's what I keep telling everyone.
So all I can figure is you're just some renegade maverick with delusions of grandeur.
I don't have any delusions, Will.
So it's a death wish then. Well, at least now we know. Only this time, your reckless actions might very well cause the death of your young friend.
How is Ivan?
Oh, I'm sure if you weren't here right now, you'd be crawling through the building ducts trying to sneak into his room to check on him. If you must know, he's in stable but critical condition, and you should know this. If he dies, I'm coming after you, Gunn.
On what grounds?
On the grounds that you're the biggest pain my poor ass has ever had in it. And if it were up to me, I'd hold you now for reckless endangerment and destruction of private property. I don't like you very much. You meddle too much.
You know, it was the Cathedral Legion and your stinking screw buckets that were blowing the place up. Why aren't you asking me about them?
None of which would have happened had you not been there. However, it turns out your intervention did prevent a murder. So tell me, who is this Dr. Stratton?
I wish I knew. I'd tell you if I did know. You know that, Will.
Yes, I suppose you would. You know, you've got to be the luckiest son of a bitch I've ever known, Gunn. And you've got friends in high places.
Herman?
Okay.
You're free to go for now. Tommy, this is not a friendly request. I'm telling you, stay out of this. Let CPU do its job.
There are only so many strings I can pull here. That Ivan kid dies.
What am I supposed to do, Herman?
Go home. Get some rest.
You know I can't do that.
Look, all I'm saying is, you may be in way over your head this time.
I'm always in over my head, Herman.
Okay. These Cathedral Legion guys are the real deal. Cold-blooded killers who shoot their own grandmothers to make a buck. We've been tracking them at CPU for years now.
Herman, this is how it is. You know me. And you know why I can't walk away from this. You know what would happen.
Yeah, I guess I do.
I'm going after Stratton. I need to find out what this Trojan is. That Jazareth guy, he told me that it would allow the Cathedral Legion to take over the world.
Well, I don't see how that's possible. Unless this Trojan is code for Ark of the Covenant or something like it.
It's something that Stratton created. But only he knows where it is, and that's why I have to get to him before the Cathedral Legion does. Herman, do me a favor. Look up Dr. Stratton's address on the CPU database.
No.
Time is critical.
Okay, Oki. But unless they follow him home, or they have access to our databases, the Cathedral Legion's a little behind the count.
Which makes the ball ours for now. Please stop calling me, okay? Give me a call. Don't be long.
This is twice now that Detective Gunn has tried to interfere with our plans.
We'll form a strike force to hunt him down specifically.
No, no. Your priorities have not changed. Besides, taking you two off his trail might quell his interest in you, Nebuchadnezzar.
That is unlikely, sir. Tommy Gunn's been after me for many years now, even before the liquidation of the 13th Legion. He's never come as close as he has today, and this is only going to fortify his resolve.
Nonetheless, you two will find Stratton and take the Trojan from him.
Where should we begin looking?
One of the advantages we have with me sitting here at the throne of CPU is the CPU databases.
What about Tommy Gunn? He will come for us and interfere again.
Oh, I wouldn't worry about Detective Gunn. He'll be far too busy dying at the hands of the outside talent I've hired. Gentlemen, allow me to introduce you to Morjask.
Bounty hunter?
Yeah, 764. Okay, I got it.
All right, thanks, Harmon.
You're welcome, Oki.
Be careful.
Who are you?
Why do you care, you murdering scum? You just want to kill me like you killed my father.
Your father? Whoa, wait. Dr. Stratton, he's your father.
Yes, my name is Janice Stratton.
Okay, listen to me. My name is Tommy Gunn, and I did not kill your father.
You lied.
If I were lying, I would have shot you already.
Your father told me that this Trojan device was the biggest mistake of his life.
He told me the same thing.
That's when they came here. That's when they killed him.
They?
The Cathedral Legion. Their boss. Asked him to make a computer program for them.
A computer program?
On the other line, when we just talked, he told me that they were here. He told me the device was in the Candy Land, that he loved me. Then the line went dead.
Janice, listen to me. Whatever this Trojan device is, it's the last thing we want falling into the hands of the Cathedral Legion. Your father knew this, and that's why he hid it. I need your help. Janice, where is this Candyland?
All right, we're clear.
Why did your father have a secret cellar?
He never met my mother. This is my secret hideout, where I used to come hide when things got rough. It's over there. What is it?
Oh, wait, I've seen this before. Yeah, back during the war. This is a transient symbian module.
A transient what?
A transient symbian module. It's kind of like the old thumb drives that we used for old computers before the war. Wait, that's it. Don't you see? You said yourself your father had been hired to do a computer program. This in and of itself isn't the Trojan device. The Trojan device is stored on this thing.
That's it? That's what my father was killed over? A gaudy thumb drive?
There's only one man that can help us. I haven't called CPU yet. How did they...
Good evening, Detective Gunn.
I'm not a detective.
I have been instructed to return with you to CPU headquarters. Please step into the back of my vehicle. Your compliance is mandatory in 10 seconds. 10. 9. 8.
Business.
7. 6. 5.
Time to go.
4. 3. Thank you for your cooperation.
Now.
get it. Why aren't they chasing us?
They're right here now.
Oh, of course. Why would they chase us when they can just be everywhere at once?
Detective Gunn, it is correct. You have both been silenced for threat testing on private property.
Oh my god, why are they chasing us?
I don't know. It's like they're malfunctioning. The Scythians, they don't miss when they get a lock on you. And those guys, they had us locked tighter in the butthole.
Detective Gunn, today's threat. Surrender now.
Well, crap. Wait a minute. We're being herded.
Herded? Herded where?
Yes. your bones break.
I didn't know where to go.
We need to get some help.
From who?
Okie, what the hell happened to you?
I had a fight with a T-Rex, Hermit.
Looks like he won.
You could say that.
Now seriously, Okie, what the hell's going on?
Real bad stuff, Hermit. Here. You recognize that?
Yeah. It's a transient Hitchamadoogie.
I need to know what's on that thing, Hermit. And I know there's only one reader over at CPU that can...
Yeah, okay, but you're hardly...
Hermit, please. A lot is riding on this. People have already been murdered over this thing.
The reader is no longer at the Civil Protection Union. It was removed about a year ago.
Oh. Crap.
I wouldn't be too down about it. Besides, I'm the one that removed the reader from the CPU.
Hermit, listen, this is really, really important. Where did the reader end up?
Well, the last time I checked, top shelf in my closet over in my bedroom. Hold on and I'll go get it.
You couldn't have just told me that to begin with.
Well, you know me, Elkie. With the way you look right now, I thought a good joke was fitting.
You let me know when a good joke shows up.
And this guy is your friend?
My best friend, actually. He just has a really bad sense of humor.
That much is obvious.
Alrighty, let's have a look, see what... There's not a lot of art included in this package. Looks like some kind of activation codec, if I had to guess.
Activation codec?
Yeah, a subroutine of some sort. It also has some spider crawlers embedded.
What's this?
You remember how the old web search systems work, right? When these bad boys go out, they not only search, they also seize.
They seize?
They don't just display the results, they take over the results.
So what does that mean?
I don't know, to be honest. I've never seen this before. There is some art attached to this module.
Synthium.
But why is the Synthium the only image on this module? Okay, what do you mean? All work and no play.
It's all your fault, Tommy. It's your fault that I'm dead.
It's your fault that I'm dead.
I'm here because of you.
I'm here because of you.
You're a failure of a husband. Your one charge was to protect and take care of us. And you couldn't do that one simple thing.
Ferris, I swear to you, I would have died for you or Emma. If I just had one more chance to relive that moment.
But you don't, do you? What has happened is what's been and ever shall be. We are dead, and you're going to have to live with that.
And you're going to have to live with that.
We are dead, and it's your fault.
And it's your fault.
Why would you?
Why would I what? Who the hell are you, boy?
I am the darkness, and the maker of it. I am the dominion, and the father of lies, thieves. I am emptiness, separation. Indeed, I am you.
House. You're resting comfortably, so we just won't let you sleep.
Denise, I never rest comfortably.
Nightmares?
Every time I stop, even for a minute.
Well, that explains a thing or two.
It's always the same. But it's always different. There are these
creatures. Demons, if you will. And they're always doing the same thing.
Exact same thing.
Killing my wife and daughter.
Oh, I didn't know you had a family.
I don't. Wait a minute. Where's Herman?
Herman's at work. People still do that, you know.
How long have I been out?
All night.
Jeez.
Where are we going?
We are not going anywhere. I've got to go home and take a shower, change out, and figure out what my next move is.
But
nothing. Denise, you'll be safer here. Herman's in the Civil Protection Union. He'll know immediately if something goes down. Besides, if the Cathedral Legion runs into me, they're more than likely going to start shooting, maybe even kill me. And I don't want you anywhere around if that happens. I don't want to be charged with your care.
Oh, gee, thanks.
I didn't mean it that way.
What do you mean?
If I got you killed too, I'm not good at looking after people.
Me killed too?
You'd be safer in a lion's den than with me, Janice. I gotta go.
Tommy! They found my father's house and they killed him too.
I wouldn't worry about it, Janice. Unless they trail me home, they're never gonna find me.
Why's that?
Because Tommy Gunn doesn't exist. I'm a figment of your imagination. You know, I never told her I loved her that last night.
Ah, Mr. Valk. Mr. Herman Valk. Please, come in, have a seat.
Thank you, sir.
Herman? I called you here today to personally meet and recognize such a long-standing member of our CPU family.
Thank you, sir. The honor is all mine.
I do this from time to time. I know there's this impression of the all-powerful CEO camped high atop the Civil Protection Union. But the thing is, I don't see myself that way. I feel like I'm part of the team. The best team the world has ever known in this field.
Of course, sir.
Enough about me, though. I feel like I'm conducting an interview here. We are here today because of you. Every now and again, certain dedication and professionalism happen to cross my desk, and when they do, I like to personally meet and thank such members of our family. In this case, that member is you, my good sir.
Well, I am. Thank you, sir.
No. Thank you, Mr. Valkyrie. Let's see here. You've spent your entire life in service. During the war against the Gyrissians and the Transians, your record here shows you as something of a courageous general.
Well, just like everyone else during that time, I was just doing my part.
You're a modest man, Herman. May I call you Herman, by the way?
Yes, sir, of course.
And please, no more of this sir stuff. Just call me Rula.
Yes, sir. Rula.
So, Herman, I did just want to go over some of the high points here specifically, during your time here.
Okay.
So, I see that when you first came on board, you headed up the original Cynthian Alpha project.
Yes, sir, I did.
What an exciting time that was, wasn't it? I remember it like it was yesterday. We were young and out to save the world.
Yes, sir, Mr. Rula. Well, not all of us were young, though.
Well, needless to say, there were a few hiccups in that program. But your leadership helped us guide through into the Cynthian Beta project.
I've always enjoyed tinkering in various disciplines.
Your leadership through the years of our Cynthian program has been invaluable, Herman. We would have never gotten to the Charlie project without your insights. For that, I thank you. I also understand that you're kind of a jokester.
Well, yes, sir. I like to keep things loose with a good joke now and then.
Ah, well. You know, If you have a few spare moments, there are a couple departmental house cleaning issues I want to go over with you.
Sure.
You were in charge of some inventory equipment, and there might have been an error made up front on the processing end. Might have caused some pretty rare equipment to be removed by mistake.
Oh?
It's an honest mistake, no doubt, no big deal. But you know government auditors. They need records for everything.
They sure do.
The piece of equipment in question is a rare piece of alien technology. Sort of a transient laptop, if you will.
Yes, sir, I know just the piece you're talking about. It was a transient symbian reader.
That's the one.
Yes, sir, I do remember that.
Turns out it should not have been removed, actually. Being that it was the only one we have, and there's only one other one known on the planet, you can see how a thing like that might come in handy from time to time. You wouldn't happen to by chance know what happened to it?
Yes, sir, I do. It ended up in the incinerator. I wouldn't worry about it too much, though, sir. The device is really more of a mantelpiece at best these days. Probably didn't even work when we threw it away, actually.
Really?
Yes, sir.
Sort of funny, actually. They were saying downstairs that you had signed it out last.
Yes, sir, I did. I took it to the incinerator myself.
Okay. Well, honest mistake. Like you said, damn thing probably didn't work anyways.
Yes, sir.
Well, okay, that aside, you had a run-in last year with the transients yourself, didn't you?
Well, yes, sir, I've had run-ins with those guys for quite some time now, I guess you could say.
Right, with the war and everything.
Yes, sir.
Well, I would be actually very interested in hearing what happened to you last year, though.
Oh, gosh, well, ever since the war, the transients have been conducting little raids on households at random. In most cases, they have killed the men in these families and flew off into space with the mothers and the daughters.
Yes, we've actually offered our full assistance to the Confederation to help curb these raids.
On this particular night, I was on my way to dropping off some stuff to an old friend. But by the time I actually got there, his home was being hit by those damn barbarians.
What did you do?
What I had to do. What anybody here at CPU would have done. I kicked in the door, front door, and took out as many of those bastards as I could. Then I drug my friend out that house, which somehow had caught fire by that time.
And his wife?
Well, that's a bit of a touchy one. The transients vaporized the house after we got out, and then they ascended into space. The house itself was completely destroyed. Nothing could have survived. Then the transient ship was intercepted by the Confederation battle cruiser on its way out. Only one of the transient ships made it.
Confederation deliberately destroyed a vessel holding human hostages?
Not actually. They took out the lead ship with an electron torpedo. Second crashed the first after it lost all power. Both were destroyed.
The third escaped?
Pulled out over the two exploding ships and zitted out into space.
I see.
The investigation which followed yielded no evidence either way to her.
That's very unfortunate.
Yes, it was.
Very sad. But I tell you this, Herman. You, sir, you are a hero. Pulling your friend out of there like that.
I've been told that, sir. But I don't think so.
Well, rest assured that I would agree with all those that call you a hero. Herman, I appreciate you taking the time to come up here and spend it speaking with me.
It was my pleasure, sir. I appreciate you taking the time to recognize me.
I do have one additional question before you go, real quick. Won't take but a second.
Yes, sir. You pay me by the hour. You can take as much time as you like.
It's one of those jokes. Good, I see. I was hoping I'd get to hear one before you left.
Yes, sir.
There was a homicide last night. It seems that Dr. Jack Stratton was killed in his home around 2200 hours.
Really? I have not seen that report.
I know, Herman. No one has yet. There was just a quick issue I wanted to go over with you before I released it. According to our system, a call was placed last night, and the address of the late Dr. Stratton was given out only an hour before the Scythian units arrived to discover the doctor's body. To be honest, this greatly alarms me.
Okay.
Given your fine record here at CPU, the access codes on the CPU database where the doctor's address was found, well, they were all registered to you. Tell me, Herman, and I'm sure there's a perfectly reasonable explanation for all of this, but why did you take Dr. Stratton's information and then forward that address out?
I don't recall doing that, sir.
Herman, I'm your friend. Help me help you. You might need a guy to cover your back, and I want to be that guy. But you're going to have to be perfectly honest with me. There's going to be an investigation into this man's murder. You know that.
I
do have a theory, and I wonder if you might be interested in hearing it. No doubt you have read the file on the crime syndicate, the Cathedral Legion.
Yes, sir, I have. Very dangerous folks.
Word on the street is they contracted Dr. Stratton to write them a software.
Is that a fact?
Herman? Let me assure you, the Cathedral Legion are indeed very dangerous. And no doubt Dr. Stratton crossed them, and that's what got him killed. You see, after he wrote it, he stored it on an old transient Symbian modem. You know, for security. Only two readers exist on the planet, one of which was in our care. Well, that is until you removed it. And don't you find it a little intriguing that this device is missing? Along with the one reader we had for it, the lookup of the doctor's address, the transmission of that address, and all of this, in some way, shape, or form, has your name attached to it.
Well, yes, sir, I suppose I do find this intriguing. But what I find more intriguing than all this is how you would have specifics about Cathedral Legion hitmen having not found their Symbian device after murdering Dr. Stratton.
Now I can see how you've been able to solve so many crimes at your time here at CPU. It's the little things, the little details people say. You capture them like a great artist, and you put them together in this wonderful picture of facts. Okay then, let's talk directly, one man to another. Herman, tell me, where is my Symbian model? And where, Herman, where is my transient reader?
Good day, Detective Gunn. You will not find a transient reader here, nor will you find your friends. Janice Stratton and Herman Valkyrie are now in our care.
They better be okay.
Well, Detective, I'm told that depends solely on what you do next. While we have acquired our reader, you are still in possession of some of our property. Without it, the reader is little more than something heavy to smash over someone's head. The symbian device that you possess should be returned to us. If you wish to ensure the safety and well-being of your friends, here is what you will do. At 1600 sharp, you will come to the docks complex. You will bring the device. You will come alone, and you will come unarmed. If you deviate from this plan, in even the slightest of manners, then we will be forced to determine just how useful this device is at smashing someone's head.
How do I know my friends are still alive?
In the time that you have known me, Detective, I have yet to lie to you. So you're just going to have to trust me. And from our perspective, if you value your friends, you don't have a choice. The docks complex, 1600 sharp. See you then.
Show if he ever wants to see his friends alive again. Does that scare you, Mr. Valkyrie?
You just put down that gun and I'll show you just how scared I am of you.
You shouldn't be so confident, Herman. We are the ones holding the guns.
There he is, right on time. Jeff, go and get it.
I hope you're not armed.
That was part of the deal.
I shot holes in your wall.
Okay, you guys. You can shoot him now.
Well, well, well. Detective Tommy Gunn. You are a hard man to get a hold of. I must commend you, Detective. You're either the bravest man and best guy ever to serve in the Confederation, or the dumbest and luckiest fool ever to cross me.
Truth is probably somewhere in between.
No doubt. And I believe we had an arrangement. You have something that belongs to me, and I have several things that are yours. As you can see, your friends are still upright and undoubtedly ready to go home for the evening.
Undoubtedly.
Which brings us to our deal. Full circle. Did you bring my simian device? How very thoughtful of you, Detective, to have it so neatly packaged for me. I appreciate that.
You're welcome.
I think now that you're here, Detective, and I've met the one man who's caused me the most problems, I'd like to modify our deal. I can see by the expression on your face that you might find this alarming. However, I think when you hear what I have to say, it will not only pleasantly surprise you, but perhaps even excite you a bit.
Think.
You, Detective Tommy Gunn, are probably not only the most cunning opponent I have ever met, but also, I think, the most experienced. Here I sit atop CPU, an organization responsible for law enforcement almost everywhere in the world, and thusly, by default perhaps, holder of the most all-inclusive civilian database ever created. And yet, no matter how hard I try, or how much I search, you, Detective, do not fully exist.
Is that a fact?
We do have a record of an attack on your home about a year ago by the transients, and how your friend Herman here pulled your butt out of the fire. The thing is, there's no history of you before what would be midway through your career in the Confederation, when you held the rank of Major.
Well, I just don't know what to tell you about it.
Yes, of course not. I'll tell you what I think. All men have a history. All men. Especially the ones who have walked in the shoes that you have. So, where were you before you went on record as Major Tommy Gunn? It's almost as if you were created. I don't know. What do you think?
I think you're wasting a lot of time with all this gunning you're doing.
Perhaps. Thing is, I know a little more about you than I lead on. It seems that you're well acquainted with a gentleman under my employee. A gentleman among us here today, actually. In this very building. Yes, you two do know each other. You aren't dead, Detective, or imagined. You are created. You are created and standing before me here today thanks to Nebuchadnezzar, aren't you? Well, the offer I have for you will require a new beginning. A fresh start, if you will. You and Nebuchadnezzar are going to have to start playing nice.
What the hell are you talking about?
Your ghost status, mixed with your obvious talents in various areas, have stimulated me more than anger. I admit, I tried very hard to have you killed. The big guy in the bike, I sent him to take care of you. Not that I didn't think Jazzer could handle it, I just required him in other areas. The Gyrizian was a force to be reckoned with, yet you dispatched him so seemingly easy, it made me, one, happy that he agreed to take the payment after the task was complete, and two, made me reconsider my reasoning for hiring your talent.
If you look, I mean real close, you're gonna see sleep start to form in the corners of my eyes.
You're right. I do tend to ramble a bit, don't I? Detective, I want you to join our team. I know for a fact we can find a home for you here in the Cathedral Legion. And whatever way it is you make your living, I can eclipse it and line your pockets with all the money you've ever dreamed of. I can make all your greatest dreams come true.
You make all my dreams come true. Can you erase the past?
I can't erase it, but I can't help you to forget about it. So what do you say, Tommy? Welcome, Tommy Gunn. Welcome to our family. They may go. Now, Nebuchadnezzar. We're turning a corner here, and trust is essential. Let them go.
Okay. Told you, Herman. Stop calling me Oki. Oki died a long time ago.
Yeah, I guess he did.
You see, Tommy, trust is what family is all about. And now that you're family, I know you've been dying to learn what you've been so effectively keeping us from.
The Trojan device.
I will show you. Give me the briefcase, and we will make history together. Tonight.
Turned out to be such a bastard.
What?
Joining up with those thugs and giving the Trojan device all for money.
Is that what you really think happened?
You saw with your own eyes, Herman.
Let me ask you something. Where are we?
I don't know. Downtown somewhere?
Let me rephrase my question. Where are we not? Do you think the Cathedral Legion would have let us all just stroll out of there, not a single hair on our heads harmed?
No. I think if Tommy hadn't given Derulo's offer, we would have all been...
I've known Oki for damn near 20 years now. I held his first child when he was baptized. I married him and his second wife, Ferris. If there's one thing I know about Oki, it's how he thinks. And I can tell you this. He knew when he came in that building tonight, the odds of any of us getting out of there alive were slim to none. Oki's greatest talent is he somehow, some way, always manages to navigate through just such scenarios. Well played, Oki.
Thanks, Herman. You two okay?
Fine.
Tommy, that was amazing.
Glad I could help.
So, what's it do, the Trojan?
He was gonna show me, but we didn't get that far, and he never said a word.
So, the mystery continues.
Yeah. You okay?
Yeah. I just want to know. And I need to know why my father was killed.
Janice. Your father was killed because the Cathedral Legion are a bunch of cowardly thugs. And he stood up to them. I was there. I saw it. He did the right thing. It's just, sometimes the right thing isn't the best thing to keep you alive.
You're a fine one to say a thing like that, Oki.
Anyway, we will find out what the Trojan does, Janice. That's a promise.
Tommy!
Very nice try, Detective. Unfortunately, your efforts, just like your life, are pointless. Very nice touch, though. Rigging the briefcase with a K-42 flasher. Well played. Well played indeed. We had a deal. One I was so graciously willing not only to honor, but to reward you for honoring your half. At least you brought it with you. And you, dear sir, fantastic work. Be sure to count it before you leave. Our deal was that you kill Tommy Gunn. Like Tommy Gunn, you failed to uphold your end of the bargain. The irony of you having more in common with Gunn than me boggles the mind. Therefore, I consider our deal null and void. I can't stand Jarvisians. They think they can come to my world and blow us away. You know what I mean, Detective? Detective, before you and your friends all die, I would like you to partake in something of a ceremony. This is the first day of the godhood of one Rula Afgar, the day the Trojan officially goes online. True enough, with the transient reader here, the Trojan will only be power enough to transmit its codes to these three Synthians. If one wants to reach all the Synthians on the planet, one needs use of the computer that they all receive their directives from. How lucky for me, I sit atop the very computer which controls that network.
CPU mainframe.
Actually, luck has nothing to do with it. This has all been by design and in the works for years now. But I digress. And after I plug all of these in, the world will be mine, instantly. Imagine, everyone, everywhere. None of them will be able to make even the slightest move unless, say, I was to approve. Martial law, my dear friends, that is the first sin. Observe.
Cynthia unit online, directed by that. Authorization task force point confirmed. Awaiting new instructions.
The control is Cynthians.
I should have offered Herman here the job I offered you. So again, I cannot thank you enough for your service to CPU, Mr. Valkyrie.
You can just go straight to hell.
Still no well-timed jokes to tell me. Too bad. So yes, Detective. A demonstration now. You've proven to be such a worthy opponent, I'm gonna allow you the greatest honors in my new and brave world. You can give my Trojan Cynthian a try. Please, give them their first directive.
Anything?
You have the floor.
Cynthians.
Awaiting directive.
Blow off Rule Afgard's head.
Halt, directive. Nice try again, Detective. Unfortunately for you, my voice overrides any and all of their commands. Cynthians, make your aim to Tommy Gunn and his two friends.
It's been an honor to call you my best friend, Loki.
Likewise, Harmon. Likewise.
I can't stand people who can't honor a simple deal, Detective. One part, though, I can give you credit for honoring. You did come unarmed. Maybe that's one part you shouldn't have honored, eh?
You sure about that, boy?
You guys taught me well by killing my sister. Always wear body armor.
You know, this is all really very interesting, Detective. And I do admire your grit. You never quit. None of it matters, though. You're all surrounded, and I am in total control.
All I want is to leave this place with my friends and the Trojan.
It's a shame that those are the only two things that aren't going to happen here tonight. Detective, do you know what separates you and I?
The fact that you have something to live for.
I suspect if you really believed that, you wouldn't have gone through all this trouble tonight. Cynthians, kill Tommy Gunn and his friends.
Your mess.
My one and only regret on that day so long ago when I visited your beautiful family is that you weren't there that day. How I wish you could have looked into your baby's eyes as he gasped for his last breath in my grip. And what was your first wife's name? Kim, was it? How she begged and cried. That was a good day.
Anything left?
Yeah, I'm not to put you over my knee if you call me old again, sonny.
Yeah.
faster, you idiot! Jasmine, give me your gun.
I don't think
so. Yeah!
Yodo!
This is bad.
That's an understatement.
Here's what we're gonna do. I went to the right to draw their fire. With a little luck, for you to break left into those racks. When you get there, whatever you see, let them have it with everything you got.
That's suicide.
I'll cut you in half.
Son, you were right. I am an old man. I've seen the Great War and I've lived to tell the tales. You two don't have any good stories to tell yet. And I intend to give you that chance.
Herman.
It's okay, Janice.
Herman? You're not doing this.
Just in case you didn't know, I was a general in the Confederation. And I'm telling you, this is what we're gonna do. It's your only chance. Okay, on three. One. Two.
Directive Asgard 1 overridden. Find directive reinstated and confirmed.
Wait. Something's happened to them.
You are in possession of illegal weaponry. Surrender immediately. Gen-Z force is authorized.
Emergency services immediately.
That is one tough son of a...
Tommy! Jazareth!
You did good, kid.
No problemo.
Pleasure, Janice.
Thank you, Ivan. How's Herman?
He'll be fine. Lost a little bit more blood than makes the doc happy, but they gave him a couple of units. He's just gonna have to learn to sit still for a while.
What about you?
Me? I'm fine. I wasn't shot.
That's not what I meant. You think you could learn to sit still for a few moments, look around, see what you're actually missing?
I wish I could, Janice. I can't, though. Besides, there'll be plenty of time for me to kick back and relax when I'm 6 foot under.
There's so much to miss, Tommy. Maybe you can sit still. Open your eyes and look at what's standing right in front of you.
My name is Gunn. Detective Tommy Gunn. See you around, Janice.
Told me that he hoped I would be ready for it. I aim to raise some hell.